Hi guys, you are watching channel Mr. Electron. This is a 220 volts universal motor from a mini mixer. You can see this is coil 1 and this is coil 2. And the rotating part in between is the armature or rotor winding. At the back, you can see the commutator. Okay, this is brush 1 and this is brush 2. And it runs on 220 to 250 volts AC or DC. So guys, this is a quartz. It is live and the output from the terminals, these two, is 220 volts AC, pointing towards 750 volts AC. And guys, as you can see that the output voltage is 258 volts AC. So guys, I've turned off the supply so that I can connect the wires safely. And once they have been connected, I will turn it on again. Yeah, so as you can see that the wires have been connected, keeping it close to the plastic cover so that if there is any strand coming out from the cables, it is on this plastic. Now let's turn on the supply. Cool. So guys, now I'm going to connect this drill chuck to the shaft of this universal motor. You see this reflecting strip? This will help in the measurement of the RPM of this motor at 250 volts AC. Okay, let's connect it. Now it is perfectly aligned. Tightening it up. Okay. Okay, so guys, let's test the alignment first. I'm going to turn on the supply. Yeah, alignment seems fine. It is not vibrating much. I think it can work out. Okay, so guys, the meter has been set and now it's time to turn on the power supply and start this engine. Okay, so guys, this time I'm holding the vise to prevent it from vibrating and running around. So the RPM is somewhere around 7000. Let's turn it off. So let's open this up. So guys, since I'm going to convert this into a DC motor, so I don't need this field winding, so let's remove it. So this is the field winding part. Let's keep it aside for future use. Now what I am finally left with are brushes, commutator and rotor or armature. Okay. Now I will need something extra for the field winding that I have removed, and I'm going to use these two large concave magnets for doing the field excitation job. And after adding this to this setup, it will become a permanent magnet DC motor. So guys, now it's time to connect the magnets, and we have to connect the magnet only on this side and this side, okay? Like here and one from here, not on this side and this side, because the brushes are touching the commutator in such a way that only this pole and this pole gets excited. This and this don't get excited, and even if it does rotate by adding magnets over this side and this side, you won't get any good torque. Okay, so it's projected on one side and not projected on the other side. It is going to create a minor difference on the torque, but I'm still going to use the sideways because it is getting better aligned this way. Otherwise it might slip at high power or speed rotation. Okay, let's connect the other one too. Okay, so the magnets have been connected, and now it's time to glue them hard and strong. Okay, so guys, as you can see that the DC motor conversion part is now completed, and the shaft is running smoothly, and now it's time to test it by applying some DC volts to it and see how fast it can run and how much torque it generates. So guys, this is a 35 volts DC supply that I am taking out from a printer. First, I'm going to measure its voltage for you, pointing a multimeter towards 200 volts DC mode. Yeah, as you can see, it is only 31 volts DC. Okay, so this side is positive and this is negative, 31 volts DC. And initially, this motor in my previous video was not running with 31 volt supply, but now it is going to run because it does not need field excitation anymore. So guys, you can see that it is running very smoothly, and also the torque should be higher than usual. Than a normal universal motor, the torque is higher, and this motor is somewhere around 100 volts. Like, understand it this way, that half the voltage from 250 volts AC was fed to the field winding, and the remaining half was fed to the rotor winding. So dividing 250 by 2, it is somewhere around 125 volts for armature or rotor winding plus 125 volts for the field winding. So the exact value of the rotor winding voltage is now 125 volts, and at present I am running it at just 30 volts DC, and for that reason the RPM is a little low, but the torque is good enough. You can see it is stopping, but it is running really good and really smooth. The wires will be connected on the brushes, of course. Okay, one is already connected red, the black one will be connected over here. You can see that the starting is smooth. Cool. Nice. So guys, somehow I have managed to get 200 volts DC supply here. So let's confirm that it is 200 with the help of a multimeter first, pointing it towards 1000, just in case if the supply is more than 200. So checking it. Yeah, you can see it is more than 200. It is 230 volts. Okay, so guys, I've connected these wires and I've disconnected this supply for safety purposes. Although it is a very risky project, I am giving it more than rated power supply DC to this, and it is going to run very fast, so anything can happen. I have to be ready for it. Okay, so guys, let's turn on the supply and see how fast it is running. Go. Wow, cool. It's not that dangerous as I thought. Running at a very high speed and smooth. I think I can increase the speed even more. Let's increase the speed. Nice. Once again, increasing the speed more. Nice. Let's see it from the rear view, how much spark it is making. That will indicate if I should run it at such a high speed or not. Starting it. Very nice. The operation is very smooth and it must be running at somewhere around 4000 RPM at present.